message and God bless you too. Look at one person that you know, shake that person and say, God will trouble your troubles here today. And every trouble of your destiny shall die. In the name of Jesus. Give a clap offering unto the Lord. Give a clap offering. You can sit down in front of someone. God bless you, Sweetheart. God bless you. God bless you. I love you so much.
Amen.
You are excellent. Hallelujah. So sorry. I can play all instruments with my mouth. With saxophone, guitar, keyboard, anything. I am born as music. In fact, my kidney is guitar. My liver is keyboard. Every part of me is with one instrument or the other. You can hear me play God with my mouth. If you have to run, you may have to run after me. Everything. Why? Ask me why. Because if you are not thankful, your tank of grace can never be full. You need grace so that you don't be disgraced. Listen to me. If you don't have God's grace over your life, you are going to wallow and be swallowed by disgrace. There are so many things in this world that want to disgrace your destiny. But it's only grace that takes you away from those things. I don't know if anybody's here that is grace. If you need grace, let me see your way in hands to Jesus. Now, there's only one way to tap grace. It is through praise. Look at somebody. The only way to tap grace is through praise. So if you are too big to praise, then you are too small to receive grace. Now, put those things down in your Bible, on your notebook. And then let it always resound in your brain. Now, if there's anybody here that is too rich to praise God, is too, educated to praise God, your intellectual capacity has made you so much pompous that you feel, I don't need to praise God, I have all that I need. Then you will be too big or too small to take grace. The only way to get grace is to praise. And your tank of grace can never be full if you don't praise God. Those that are not thankful cannot be fruitful. Or those that are thankful alone can be fruitful. Listen to me. That is you always say, if you diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, and then that was from Deuteronomy 28, it will bless your going out by your word, coming. Those things cannot come to you if you are disobedient. I've always told people, if you cannot follow the pattern in the scripture, you don't have a future. If you cannot what? Follow the pattern in the word, in the scripture, then you don't have a future. Forget about your future. Because your future is hidden in the scripture. You are the continuity of somebody that has ever existed somewhere. God as a person is transferring from ancestors to ancestor. And that is the topic of what we're going to discuss today. Destiny. It's either you are in destiny or you are in destitute. It's either you receive your destiny or you are destitute in this planet. If you don't have destiny, then you are just walking amiss. You are walking on your own way. Jesus said, the Son of Man goeth as it is written of him. So this morning, quickly, we will look at reviving your destiny, or we'll call it the mystery of destiny. If you are choosing a career or you are choosing a way of life without understanding that there's something called destiny, then I tell you, you are not supposed to be living. It's better for you to be taken away from this planet because you are walking like a serpent on a rock that will never have a path. Your footprints must be left on earth. You must live here with an impact, but you cannot make an impact if you are not part of God's plan. God has an agenda. God has a plan. The plan is your destiny. The plan is your destiny. And your destiny, you must understand it and study it before you can say you are walking by it. Dearly beloved, there are so many people on earth that have chosen a career, chosen a way of life outside their divine purpose. Your destiny is your purpose in life. Your destiny is that which the Creator wrote concerning you. Your destiny is the script written by the actor called the Creator for you to act as an actor or actress. Listen, You have a script. Everybody is participating in a play. The earth is a what? It's a play stage. The play stage where we are acting a movie. Look at somebody and say, God is watching your movie. Are you a boss or an actor? Answer. Are you a boss or an actor? I just want you to picture this message with scripts and actors and actresses. Of course, you know, you like watching African magic, Nollywood and Hollywood. You like watching all those things. But you don't know, you have not realized that you are acting a movie. The Bible says there are 12 witnesses standing above that we cannot see, that are watching the plays, that are watching the movie, and are watching the film you are acting. You don't know. If you don't know, better know now. I've just come to sensitize you. I've come to open your understanding to knowing that you are an actor acting a movie. Unfortunately, you know this story. If Ramsey Noah is meant to be the actor and they gave him a script to understudy and to study it and then play it out in a movie, and they gave him that script, and after they did it, they got to the time they are supposed to start the film, they started acting and acting. What will happen to the owner of the film? Can I hear somebody talk to me? What will happen to the actor and the owner of the film? They will have to fight. And of course, the writer of the movie has the right to sack the actor. How many of you know? How many of you know? The owner of the movie has the right to what? To sack the actor. If the actor is not acting what the writer of the movie wants, he will sack the actor. And of course, that will be a serious case. And if he kept on doing that from movie to movie, from movie to movie, nobody will invite him to come and act any movie again. And then from superstar, he become a person with no star. I pray for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will not be dropped from superstar to no star. So many people will be deranged in heaven. After they tell them, son, daughter, depart from me, you worker of iniquity. I know you not. So many people feel workers of iniquity are people that are committing sin alone. The greatest sinner in the universe is somebody that does not know what is written concerning his or her. The greatest idiot, the greatest fool, the greatest nincompoop, so to say, that is the father of fool you can talk about, is a person that does not know who he or she is. Before you left heaven, how many of you come from heaven? If you are from heaven, let me see your hands up. If you are from heaven, let me see your hands up. Okay, if you are not from heaven, then you should be from hell. So if I'm from hellfire, let me see your hands up. Hey, well, hey, because you don't want to see. Let me ask again, if you are from heaven, let me see your hands up. Hey, they are raising their hands. If you are from hell, let me see your hands up. Yoruba people say, Aye Lodja, or Renekini. That means you came from somewhere. And that's just not an ordinary saying. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5 confirms that. Can I hear somebody read? Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5. Anybody there? Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5. Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew. The question is where? Who is talking there? To who? To you. Don't say Jeremiah. Jeremiah is dead and gone for life. And I hear you read it and put your name as if God is talking to you. Before what? I formed thee. Mention your name. Before I form Mark in the belly, I know him. Before he cometh from out of the womb, I am what? Sanctify him. And ordain him as a what? Prophet unto what? And if you are not a prophet, say, and ordain him as a teacher. And ordain him as a president. And ordain him as a what? Lawyer. And ordain him as an engineer. And ordain him as a what? A doctor. As and ordain him as what? A professor, so to say, and so on and so forth. Before you were born, something spectacular was meant for you. Whenever I read this scripture, I get a lot. I say, oh, that was why I started my own journey from 7 years old with the full understanding of who I am. And from 7 till now, I pray to God that I will never miss my mark.
My life is a living example
of destiny.
And when God told me, this same thing I wrote concerning Jeremiah is meant for you,
I have ordained you as a prophet
unto nation.
So I saw it to myself. I am going to work towards becoming a prophet of the nation, that one day Nigeria will not be able to do anything without consulting me.
So I'll become a special advisor to the president on spiritual matters. It becomes a vision, because when you don't have vision, you die in confusion. Your destiny must be what prompts your vision in life. Because without vision, the Bible says people will perish. The greatest revival I can give to you today is to revive you back into your destiny. The ability to build you back into your destiny is a great failure. If you have not asked yourself a question, what am I here to do on earth? Then there's nothing for you to arise and shine with. Shine with what? Shine astray or shine on target. You can be a singer or a musician, and your destiny is supposed to be an accountant. And everybody knows you all over the world, like Philio. For example, Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson was supposed to be the greatest music evangelist in the world, far better than John Wayne. He was given power to sing, and even they bring dead to that place, the dead will rise. Of course, you see it manifesting the other way around. When Michael Jackson sings, you see people faint the other side. But they saw him as a child from 8 years old. And they saw that he had the greatest star. In fact, he was meant to ridicule Lucifer. He was created with the dynamic stars and music power of Lucifer that God sent him to the world. Go and make Lucifer cry with your gifts. He was given ability to sing and sing power. In fact, he was clouded. He was clothed with what? The spirit of Shekinah. He was carrying the glory of God, but he never knew. The greatest failure is Michael Jackson's father and mother. Their parents are the greatest fool that ever seen on earth.
Parents have made great mistakes. They have a child for 9 months in their womb, and they have not bothered to ask God, what is the name of this child I'm carrying? And when they came to the world, you see them struggling and fighting for the name. The father will say, this is what I want to call child. The mother will be fighting. That's the greatest abomination I've ever seen. When Jesus was born, who named Jesus? Who named Jesus? When John was about to be born, who named John? An angel of the Lord came from heaven, called Gabriel, and spoke to them and said, this child is coming to do so thing. And the name of the child is who? John. And when they were about to name that child outside destiny, the father that was dumb before, who said, don't spoil the life of my child. His name is not what? Zechariah Jr. His name is what? John. Because by the name of a child, the destiny can be readdressed. What is your name? And who gave you that name? Who told you that is your name? And why are you walking the way you are walking? If a child is named Judas, well, he may end up betraying everybody. If a child is named Michael, then he may end up defending everybody. Even where the devil called him to come and intervene, he will go there and go fast. How many of you have seen Michael doing that before? How many of you know any Michael around? They are very, very stubborn. How many of you know? Have you noticed? Oh, you are not talking. Any Michael, just go and name your child Michael. The child will get strong head. Any Michael in the house? Any Michael in the house? They will not want to raise up their hand. Why? Because Michael means defender. The name of a child has a lot to say about the child's destiny. Now, if you name your child a name outside divine, God's divine ordinance, you are going to run into trouble. I will quickly say this if you want to write, if you care to write. Everything on earth has destiny. Everything on this planet has destiny. Everything on earth has destiny. Anything without a destiny is nothing. Anything without a destiny is what? It's nothing. Anything is without a purpose will never reach anywhere. Anything without an ordination can never get to a destination. Anything that is not moving with vision will end up in confusion. Anything that is not working with God directing will end up becoming a destitute. Dearly beloved, if you want to fulfill destiny, then you must ask yourself the following question. Number one, where am I coming from? Where am I and where am I going to?
And if I ask you, where are you coming from? Everybody say from heaven. Are you sure you are not from Satan? Are you sure you are not from devil? Because devil also has his own children on earth. If not, they will not say you generation of what? Vipers. John the Baptist said, you generation of what? Vipers. Who has warned you about the days of evil that is to come? Because there are some people called generation of vipers. And on the other hand, they are generation of evil. Those are the people that says, at the end of everything, if the battle is too much for you, I will strengthen you with the strength of what? Of an eagle. I will give you the wings of an eagle to fly. And so in this generation on earth presently, we have the generation of eagles and vipers. Which one do you belong to? Are you an eagle or from the generation of vipers? If you're from the generation of an eagle, then your place is in the sky. You are not supposed to be walking in the, as a chicken. And I must tell you the truth. The way you know if somebody is from the chicken republic or the eagle republic is the attitude when they get to church. There's no way you hear the voice of an eagle like you that you will not fly. There's no way you get to the presence of God, beholding the glory of God, that you will not swear and shout for joy. Anyone from the chicken republic, they can never do better than the way they are doing. Have you ever seen a chicken fly in the head? Have you ever seen the chicken taken up and fly like an eagle? Listen very well. If you belong to generation of you are an eagle, but you have turned yourself to a chicken, then you are going to be at the mercies of the python or the serpent. You will be sick to death. In this generation, God expects you to soar as an eagle, but you can never walk as an eagle if you have not understand what is called destiny. Destiny is what God said concerning you before you were born. Destiny is a script written by God concerning you. Destiny is what you are predestined to do, your purpose of coming to the earth. So therefore, listen and listen very well. If you don't know that everything on earth has a destiny, then you will learn from this story. The light, ever since God created the light, he said light will shine and darkness will not work, comprehend its meaning. Destiny of the light is to shine and chase away darkness. So if there be no light again, the darkness overcomes everything. The destiny of the sun is for the sun to bring forth light and darkness will depart. The destiny of the moon is to shine forth light at night. The destiny of the star is to beautify the sky at night. What is your own destiny? If an animate object has destiny, if elements have destiny, then human also should have destiny. And your destiny is distinct from that person seated by your side. And you must learn to understand that that destiny that has been prepared for you, that's been written concerning, you must search it out. Before you were formed, God has a purpose for you. Let's take an example of somebody's destiny file. I talk about destiny file because there is a file written concerning you. Before you were sent forth from heaven to the air, before you journeyed from God to this planet, listen very well. Before you were formed in the womb, God sent an angel to watch over you, and that angel is called your guardian angel. Some of you believe with me that you have a guardian angel. Now the question is that have you ever seen your guardian angel? Have you ever heard the voice of your guardian angel? Do you know the name of your guardian angel? Of course, we know that of Jesus Christ. Before Jesus was born, Gabriel came and spoke to the mother about Jesus. And said, this is the child that you are carrying, and this is what it's going to be. And the Bible says, Jesus, go as it is written of him. Are you also moving as it is written of you? Have you ever inquired the Lord and asked the Lord that God, can I hear the voice of a guardian angel? Has your angel appeared to you in any form in a dream, telling you something and showing you the way you should go? If the answer is no, then you are dead than you are deader than dead. That means that's English. You are what? Deader than what? That means you have died a long time ago. You are seated there and you are 20. You don't know what you are sent to do, what to do. You are still guessing. Even perhaps when you were in secondary school, you joined them to go to a department. You say, what do you want to be? You say, doctor. So let me go and become a doctor too. There's no specification. But the problem there is that so many people don't know. And the first person that's supposed to know the destiny of the child is the mother. You are carrying a child in the womb. For that period of 9 months, your question to God is, God, show me the destiny of this child. For a period of 9 months, you are supposed to dream. Your dream life is designed to show you the next step you are meant to take. How many of you here have never had a dream, and in the next day, it didn't come to pass the way you saw it? How many of you here?
I've had a dream, and the dream the next day, the thing came to pass before you said it. If it is once in a while, you are dying so small. You have to wake up.
But it's supposed to be every day. Why do I say that? Your dream is a machine created by God, slot into the back of your head for cities of your life to be slotted day and night. And activities you are meant to engage yourself in the next minute are meant to be slotted into your head. In case you forget, when you sleep between 5 minutes, they slot it again for you to play it out. You are meant to be reading your script every day. As a matter of fact, your guided angel is meant to read your script to you every time you sleep. If possible, act it for you like a movie. And that's why you see yourself sometimes, you suddenly see yourself, you are a lawyer, you are now in a court premises, and you are talking to, you know, other lawyers. And then you wake up and say, ah, maybe God wants me to become a lawyer. It's not maybe. That angel is trying to tell you, you are going to study medicine. You are not supposed to study medicine. You are a lawyer. Now, if you don't keep by it, you are going to become a doctor and at the same time give somebody injection of death and be arrested and put into prison. Why? Because you're in the wrong track. You can't be running the wrong race of life. You need to revive back to understanding what you are said to do. If a mother is carrying a child for 9 months, and at the end of the 9 months, you cannot account or say, this is what I saw about the child. That woman is a useless woman. If you don't know now, you are not married, or you are married, or you are just 20, 18, above, and you go and ask your mother, mommy, excuse me, ma'am, when I was in the womb or when I was small, did you ever see anything concerning me? If your mother said yes, congratulate her and tell her to tell you what she saw. Because your angel is meant to tell your parents exactly what to have. They are not just your parents, they are caretaker. How many of you know that parents are caretaker? And before you can take care of something, you must ask a person that is giving you that property, isn't it? Caretaker is meant to take care of somebody's property, isn't it? You are whose property? God's property. I mean, if you are Satan's property, shout hallelujah. Satan's property are there. Now, if you are God's property, the caretaker that are supposed to be your parents are supposed to ask that owner of the property, this property you gave unto me, what do you want me to do with it? And after they ask, the Bible says, ask and shall be what? Seek and shall what? Knock and shall be what? God has given you that instruction. Ask. And if your mother said he knows, oh, I have asked and God has told me who you are, take your pen and write it down, because that is the route you are going to follow. You don't know, you don't have your destiny file with you as a hard copy. You don't know what is written concerning you. You don't have your destiny map. You are walking as a what? A destitute, instead of you walking in destiny. As you're sitting there, ask yourself this question. Do I know who I am? Or you are just walking by what I call imagination? Or you are walking by what I call intuition? And what you are walking by what I call just, you know, you are fascinated, or you are following a mentor, or you saw somebody on the TV and say, maybe I am meant to be like this. And you start pursuing that kind of life. You are dead. You need to go back to life. Some parents will say, oh, what do you want to become my child? And the child will say, I want to become a doctor. And say, that's good. Your father was a doctor. That's a shame on you. You're asking the child what should become. When the Bible says, train up your child. The way he should what? Go. When he grows up, he will know what? Some people think you are just talking about morals. But I'm not talking about morals here. We are talking about the way the child should go. That is the destiny of that child. You must tell that child. It's your duty. Now, when you were in the womb, for a period of 9 months, while I was carrying you, God showed you this. To the extent God will show you the name, the first name. Why? Because behind the fire, there must be what? A name. And so, when you were sent from heaven, I mean your spirit man, that's why it's not possible for a person to be pregnant one day and give birth the same day. It takes how many period? 9 months. Why? Can't God just form that child within a day and he grows up? Oh, let me ask you a question. When Eve was coming out of Adam, was she a baby? When Eve was coming out of Adam, was she a baby? How old was she when she came out of Adam? question. An adult. How old? The same age with what? Adam. That's what I want to hear. It was the same age, the same height, the same size, the same look. Only that God gave some structure that made Adam to say, wow. It was exactly like the twin of Adam, but in another word, another form. And what's the difference? The breast, the shapes. And I would say, wow, this is a woman more beautiful than myself. God just made an advanced man. Now talk to somebody by side, if you are a man, say, we gave back to you. I didn't want to hear that. Look at somebody that says, we gave back to you. Because you see them at any time, they will tell you, if you don't drink a woman's breast, excuse me. So he said, according to the Bible, we gave birth to you. Confirm it anywhere. There's no science that can turn this thing upside down. It's there. It's an everlasting truth. Nobody can change it. Men gave birth to women. Want to talk to somebody here? Men gave birth to what? There's no, don't contest it. It's not possible. It is written. And what is written cannot be changed. And so when Eve came out of Adam, she was a grown-up world person. Now God saw something that made him change the order. Because if you were to have a child too, what would have happened by now is that you are married today. And then if by God's making, okay, who came back to Jesus? Who came back to Jesus? No. Who said that there? What did you say? Holy Spirit. How? Explain. You said? That's not what I'm saying. You see, sentiment has entered. Women are jealous. Jealousy. That's not what I'm saying. You're jealous. I'm not saying men came back to Jesus this time. Who came back to Jesus? Simple question. Who? The Bible says, and Mary was pregnant of what? The child of the Holy Ghost. They didn't say the child of God. They didn't say that. They said the child of what? The Holy Ghost. It means inside Mary, Holy Spirit was pregnant with Mary. But because Jesus needed a body, a flesh, he needed to come through who? A woman. In other words, Jesus was not conceived by sexual copulation, but what I call divine impartation. The Bible says the Holy Spirit overshadowed Mary. I want to tell you what it means. That in the spiritual realm, there is no sexual intercourse. There's always a proclamation that becomes generation. That is, God called things that be not as if they were, He can call invisible out of invisible. In other words, when God wanted the whole earth to exist, all he needed to do is to speak to the Holy Spirit, which is a productive being of the Trinity. How many of you agree with me that God has a family? And the name family that we have on planet Earth in the spiritual earth is not called family, but it's called Trinity. So the word for family in the spiritual realm is called what? So when you are saying Trinity, it's like you are saying God's family. Watch out somebody here. Now have this idea in your brain. That everything that God created was not by magic. It was by what I call divine regeneration. Now we call our own reproduction. God called his own word? Impartation. Or spiritual regeneration. When God wants to reproduce something after his kind, or he wants to create something, the person that goes ahead to do it for him is who? Holy Spirit. Now listen to me. When Jesus was about to come to the world, he just said, Holy Spirit, go to the world and produce Jesus. They don't need to romance and hug, as we do. What brought forth sexual intercourse was sin that Adam committed. He said unto God, the woman you gave unto me. By slighting God, saying, I didn't ask for a wife, you gave me a wife. And I don't need it. So now, what has happened? Now you are blaming. You can't blame me. The woman you gave unto me, and God said, I won't be your affairs again. I'll back off. You do your own thing yourself. And that's what reduced you to when you were coming from the world, from the womb, you were a baby. You have to grow by yourself. If anything happens to your growth, you're on your own. You become a dwarf. For example, I can have a book. God did not destine them to be a dwarf. Now, because Eve was not a dwarf, he was a full grown woman. But listen to me. What I want to pass across to you is that God said, Holy Spirit, go. Go and possess Eve. Can I have a man here? Can I have a man come up here? This is Mary. This is the Holy Spirit. What the Holy Spirit did was that he became her size and entered into her with the pregnancy. And so if the Holy Spirit is inside, whose tummy will be portrayed? Am I talking to somebody? Have I proved that? Is that acceptable? Because if by the making of God, you have to accept the woman before what? Before you have a baby. And there was no sex. What happened? A pregnant being entered into somebody that is not what? And they both gave birth to it. So the blood of Mary was used to form the body of Jesus, isn't it? And so Jesus came up with the body. Without Mary, there's no body for Jesus. Of course, you know for sure that the Bible says that child belonged to the what? Holy Ghost. And Joseph could not claim ownership of who? Of Jesus. God, Joseph. When they asked him, he said, I am doing the business of my what? He was lost for 3 days. And he told, excuse me, please. I know you and you know me. If not by anything, I'm not your mate. I am the creator of the world, if you know. I belong to a royal family name. Because I was born in a manger does not mean I'm a messenger. Look at somebody here. That you were born in a manger does not mean you are a messenger. No matter your situation, now you must know who you are, Jesus knew who he is. Then they asked his disciples one day, who do you think I am? And they said, you are rabbi, you are this, you are that. He said, no. Can anybody talk to me? And Peter said, yes, I know you. Now I was son of the living God. Wow. He said, flesh and blood have done what? Look at somebody and say, you have a spiritual personality inside you. Touch yourself and say, this is just a house. Discover the you in you. The original in you, you must discover. Because if you don't discover, you can never recover. That's my point today. There is a spiritual personality inside of you that has a powerful capacity. Michael Jackson do not know who he is until few days to his death. He was looking for freedom. He knew that there was something about him that was not being, you know, reactivated. Because no one can be activated without Christ. You are just as useless as a SIM card without activation. The spirit inside of you cannot be activated without Jesus Christ. And that's why you need to give your life to Jesus before you can be activated. And so anybody without Christ, they are working outside divine purpose. Because the whole process of using a SIM card is that if you buy MTN card, you call MTN customer care, isn't it? And they will activate the SIM for you before you can use it. The same procedure is attached to the humanity. That if humanity is not in partnership with divinity, there cannot be productivity. Am I talking to somebody here? If humanity does not seek to go in partnership with what? Divinity. There's no what? Productivity, meaning you can't be anything useful without connecting back to your family, the Trinity. In other words, God the Father is the Father. Jesus is what? The Son. Who is the Mother? Holy Spirit. Just as your Father, Mother, the Holy Spirit is the Mother Spirit, is the one that bears offspring. Remember, when he was creating the head, he said the Spirit of God was moving what? From the surface of the deep. And he said, let there be what? And there was light. Meaning, who created the whole thing? The Holy Spirit. Through the power of the Word that was always inside him. Who is the Word? John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word. And God. Who is that Word in the Bible? The Bible said the Word became what? Flesh. And dwelled. And the light of that world shined forth, and darkness was. Now, who is that one?
Jesus.
Am I talking to somebody? At the time the Holy Spirit left the throne, why the Father was still seated there?
Why?
Ask me. The reason is that Satan has once planned coup to take over God.
How many of you know?
And if they have tried to take over your throne before, what will you do? If you have capacity to make yourself omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent, what will you do? You will rather share yourself into many places and begin to appear. Now, what God did was seated, but he sent forth his spirit and Jesus that were still inside the Holy Spirit as at then. And they were creating everything. Listen, the Bible says when they said, let there be light, there was what? Was it said, and God made light? So if it were not to be the problem between God and Adam, if you marry, what you should do is to say, Jumoke, can you please give me Isaac? Without stress, Isaac will walk out of Jumoke for you. What about somebody here? You have a wife. She doesn't need to go through 9 months of stress. I need you to give me a child after my likeness that looks exactly like me. And as you are saying that, just like a computer, the thing will be forming in her the same way you imagine it. And after formation, you saw say, I want you just like a photocopy machine. You will bring back your original copy, carbon copy, without going to stress. But it was curse that made a woman to carry a baby for what? Yet, after giving back to that child, the child will not be able to what? To talk. The fourth day Eve came out, was she deaf and dumb? Imagine somebody here. Now, when he came out, when she came out, she was able to look at who? Adam. And they were able to talk. And that was the whole process. But because Adam said, the woman you gave unto me. God said, I'm going to snow down the person. Everything about you, you are all white, old. But you don't know what? You're your own. But yet, God did not back off totally. Why? Because he is interested in the seed. He said, the seed of the woman, serpent, the seed of the woman will break the head of what? And you will what? You bruise his heel. Listen to me. You are the seed of a woman. How many of you here are born of a woman? After that, the process changed. And the woman has to produce what? Now, it was the pronunciation that made women to start carrying a baby for 9 months. And the Bible says, God said, in pain, you will what? And to your husband, your interest, your affection shall be for life. It's a curse for you not to be able to sleep without a man. Tell them. It's a serious curse. If your husband did not come by 12 o'clock, you're already panicking. Oh, hello, hello, darling, where are you? It's a curse. You won't be able to stay alone without us. Am I talking to somebody? Women will not like me. I don't care. That's the Bible. But listen to me. Where I'm going today is this. All those things you are going through now, it was a change of destiny from the days of Adam. So many things were lost. Part of the things that was lost is your consciousness to know where you are coming from, where you are, where you are going. Adam knew what she was meant to, Eve knew what she was meant to do the day she came out. She was mature, she was wise. Everything that you need now to know is dependent on your parents. When you come out, they are the ones to tell you what they saw concerning you, the father and the mother. Did they tell you anything? Answer my question. Did they tell you anything they saw? Did they narrate your dream, the dream they had when you were in the womb? Did they tell you sin one? Did they tell you sin two? Did they tell you sin three? Did they tell you sin whatever sin your destiny has? Age one, there's something they're supposed to see about age one, age two, age three. These are the sin of your life. As a matter of fact, the chapters of your life are your age. What age you are now, if you are 33, you are in chapter 33. In fact, in chapter 33, you are supposed to. Who told you you are acting in high scripts? Dearly beloved, I'm pushing you to say, I want to know who I am. I want to know the me. There's something God said about you. Before your spirit left heaven, before you journeyed to the world, there was something written about you. Check Isaiah chapter 11 very fast. Isaiah chapter 11
from verse 1.
You see an example of a destiny fire written there.
Isaiah chapter 11 from verse 1. Quickly.
Isaiah 11. Listen to this destiny fire. And they shall come forth a rod out of the stem of what?
Jesse.
Now put your father's name in Jesse.
And they shall come forth a what?
A rod. That's just an example. That rod represents who? Say, and they shall come forth a doctor from the family of Jesse. Do you understand? And by the name they give to you, Toluwalope shall grow out of that ancestry.
Now, go ahead, verse 2.
And listen, this child will not be an ordinary child. And the Spirit of God shall be upon this child. The Spirit of wisdom, 2. The Spirit of understanding, 3. The Spirit of counsel, 4. The Spirit of mind, 5. The Spirit of knowledge, 6. The Spirit of the fear of God, 7. He will be packed with 7 special spirits. Now listen to me. If you give birth to a child that is born with the spirit of excellence, those children are very sharp. One of them is a child that is sharper than you. More intelligent than you. You are asking questions that you may want to ask. She's school related to God's son. Did they teach this child this one in school? And the kind of question the young boy is asking you, even as an adult, you'll be amazed. They took Jesus Christ to Jewish school, and they took and they tell the teacher to teach him.
This was not the story written in the Bible. It's written in the Jewish text.
And they were reading the alphabet for Jesus. Jesus finished A to Z in few minutes. And then construct a sentence and gave the teacher to pronounce it. And the teacher could not do anything. The rabbi had to send him back home. That's why you cannot hear about Jesus Christ that he ever went to any secondary school or primary school or university because he knew more than the teacher. Yes, he did not go to any school. He got to the temple and was teaching doctors, professors, and all. What was he teaching them? He was teaching them the size of the moon, the size of the sun. He was telling them the exact shape. That kind of child that has that kind of spirits. What? Who else will teach that child in school? He wouldn't want to go to school. Jesus was born with 7 spirits. How many spirits? He had the spirit of what? Wisdom, understanding, counsel, mind, knowledge, and what? That means in him lies all knowledge. He knows everything before he was born. That's why he could teach professors, and professors could do. They cannot, they wonder. For 3 days, they had to ask him to wait there, and they were teaching. He was teaching them for 3 days, they were writing. And the parents were looking for him. When they saw him and said, excuse me, where are you coming from? He said, excuse me, sorry. I went ahead doing the business of my father. And the mother said, mom, you know, when you saw a child, told that by dwelling up, that's wiser than you. I said, mom, because you didn't have a car, because you have a car, you have a car, what would you say? Mom, if a child looks at you and says, excuse me, why are you looking for me? I'm doing what I'm sent to do. So what is it? And he started explaining to you. Tolu, are you the one? Say yes, I'm the one. Are you okay? I'm okay. May God open your understanding. Because if you know who you are, if they tell you that you were born with the spirit of a judge, you will not struggle to be a scientist. You will go as it is written of you, and you will speed up. Why? Because what is a human speak for? Jesus was born as a savior. Although he was born in a manger, he knew he was not a messenger. He was a master. He was a messiah. And they had disciples at the time. He began to look for disciples. John the Baptist, that was supposed to have known Jesus more than himself, he said to him, he said, this is the person in whose shoes are Jesus, and what is the word? Daughter, where do John know Jesus? The Bible says where Elizabeth saw Mary, the baby inside her was lived. It means John was a spiritual child inside the mother. You are also a spirit living in a body, meant to walk on earth for a while and then go back to the realm of divinity. Therefore, your purpose of knowing Christ is that God should restore to you or to activate in you your original. I'm praying for somebody here that Jesus that you have known will activate your original. Yeah. I can't hear another amen. Yeah. Jesus today will activate your what? Original. Because a child that is born without Jesus is like a SIM card that has not been activated. If your parents has failed, if there were no prophets in your family that could tell you who you are, this is Prophet Isaiah talking about a child that has not been born, that will be born in the next 2,000 years. He was talking about Jesus, that a child will be born. At another place, he said, a child will be born unto us, that the kingdom will be on his world, shoulder, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, because God. Everything about Jesus was told to Prophet Isaiah. Who is your own prophet too? The Bible says, Hosea 12:13 says, by a prophet, Israel is what? Led out of captivity. By a prophet, Israel is what? Preserved. The Bible told Moses, he said, God told Moses, tell the children of Israel, I wish that all of you be a what? A prophet. Who is a prophet? A seer into the future. May God open your prophetic eyes. May God open your eyes of revelation. What I'm here to do today is that if your parent has failed and there was no prophet on your streets that would tell your parents who you are, or your children, your parents could not even see the destiny you carry, or even you yourself, you don't even know at 40, at 20, at 15, whatever age you are, you don't even know what is written concerning you. You cannot even explain the scripts that God said about you. You are just an actor acting a script you don't know anything about. Satan has even given you a script to act. If you are meant to be a doctor and now you end up being a conductor, it's a double tragedy. You must discover who you are. 7 steps to discovering who you are because of time. The number one step you must know. You must know the Creator. Know the what? The Creator. Why should you know the Creator? He's the writer of your scripts. After knowing the Creator, then know the best actor. Who is the best actor? Jesus Christ of Nazareth. That's why the Bible says, looking unto Jesus, the what? The author and the what? Finisher. Because when Jesus died, he said, it is what? He understood the destiny from chapter 1 to chapter 33. Jesus had 33 chapters. How many what? 33 what? Chapters. At the end of everything on the cross, it is what? And that's why the Bible says, as an actor, you must look at a best actor, which is the author called Jesus Christ, as your mentor. Therefore, are you that you want to be a good actor in the script of life? You must look at the author and the finisher, the one that did the justice to his own destiny. Then you must look at him. Then when you look at the author and the finisher of your faith, which is Jesus Christ, by accepting him as your Lord and your what? Accept that there is God, that he has sent his son to the world to die for you, to activate you into who you are supposed to be, which is Jesus Christ. After knowing Jesus, let me tell you, the next thing you must know is who you are. Know God. Know his only begotten son, then know who you are. Who will tell you who you are? It's Jesus Christ that knows who you are. And how will he tell you? He can speak to you through what we call the scripture. Why? Your future is hidden in the scripture. I repeat, you are the continuity of a script written. I must ask you, do you know if you are the next Daniel? Do you know if you are the next Esther? Do you know if you are the next Deborah? Do you know if you are the next Elijah? Why? Because these scripts are transferred from generation to what? Generation. You can't just be saying, I am a spiritual Jew. If a spiritual Jew, then you must continue the script of the Jew. Am I talking to somebody here? You must discover what he said about you. Then I discovered something about Donald Trump. I discovered Donald Trump was meant to continue the destiny in Isaiah 45. How many of you know Donald Trump? If you hate him, let me shout you shout hallelujah. If you hate Donald Trump, let me hear you shout hallelujah. You will not talk now. You say his kids are too big and he talks anyhow. The evil that builds Africa is your business. Donald Trump is not called Trump in the physical, in the spiritual realm. To us here, it's called Trump, but in the spiritual realm, it's called trumpet. I made a discovery about Donald Trump. I knew that he was acting a script that is written in Isaiah 45. When you get to go and read the destiny of Donald Trump in Isaiah 45, you discover that he doesn't need to be a Christian before he will do what God wants him to do. He was meant to arise in America and return America back to the United States that it used to be by being in the center of the eternal city of Jerusalem. He said something in speech that makes me discover. When you write Jerusalem, quickly write Jerusalem on your notes. Jerusalem. Then in the midst of Jerusalem, you will see USA, right? Jerusalem. As everyone is there, then cycle US what? Hey, in his speech, he said, we will return US embassy back to the eternal world's capital called Jerusalem. What is Jerusalem? Jerusalem is a city called the city of the Prince of Peace. Meaning, Jerusalem means peace. And in the Bible says Melchizedek is the Prince of what? Salem, the King of Salem. Meaning, U.S. and Israel will lock up together. Any country that becomes friend to Israel becomes a friend of God. And Obama in his own tenor that was meant to be another Nimrod of our generation. Who is a Nimrod? A Nimrod is a person that was meant to be a defender. Genesis chapter 10 talks about Nimrod. He said he was a great hunter before the Lord. What does it mean? In this generation, Obama is meant to slaughter ISIS. How do I know? And the first tenor of Obama, he killed Osama. How can Obama kill Osama? Bush could not kill. Clinton could not do anything. All of them, they could not fathom what will kill Osama. But when Obama got there, Obama now killed what? Osama. That spells his destiny. Michael Jackson was looking for who to help him at the head of the day. He could not find. I wish Michael Jackson knew Nigeria. I wish you could come to meet Daddy Adeboye in those days, because Daddy Adeboye, his destiny is meant to control the king. That's why it's Adeboye, Adetobaoye. You can see his destiny. That's why he was with governors, president, and all these men. He was meant to produce them. He was meant to rule them. He was meant to lead them. That's why he's meant. Now, what is your name? Obama, that was meant to destroy ISIS now, eventually was nailed because he wanted to become the most influential person on earth. And he never knew Christ. So he felt he should be a normal person. He should just be somebody supporting globalization. And he should just support, you know, civilization. And he was doing modernization until he get to crazyization. And then he put legal legislation. And then he begins to sign all sorts of dirty laws and put it on. Why? He wants to become most accepted in the world. He lost it. Why? He was not a light. So he went into darkness. He failed again as Nimrod too. If he had known, he would not have failed. Donald Trump, you will hear him say, from today, how many of you watch that inauguration? How many of you, if you don't watch it, then you are not a Nigerian. In fact, I will deport you from this country to Ghana. Don't like him. It's because you're not conversant with the word of God. Excuse me. And he said, today, as from now, I will get rid of ISIS. He said it. You can't be talking like that. Where are their snipers? ISIS are not joke. They are specially trained by U.S. Army. They can fire anybody. But he said, I will wipe them out. Wow. Read Isaiah 45. You will see his destiny again. That's where I'm going to end. Listen to me. You must search who you are. And the person that can search, that can tell you the way to go, is the way. The Bible says, Jesus is the word. The truth and what? No one can go to the Father except what? I help with this. You must know your destiny. And you must have your destiny map and your destiny far. So as for you to know your destination. And the only person that can tell you is the best actor, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher. And so, if you are not giving your life to Jesus, dearly beloved, you need to surrender your life to him now. He knows what to tell you.
He knows what to do. He will give you revelation and information about your destiny that will lead you to your destination. It's time for you to sign your life. Can I have everybody stand on your feet?
That will not permit me to go on and on and on and on and on and on. When next we meet again, we'll be able to do some prayers together. But today, just pray three and then we'll go. Look at somebody by your side. If there's anything you are looking for now,
look for who will tell you about your destiny.
Can I tell you something? Are you listening to me, please? Donald Trump went to some people like Rick Jonah. How many of you have read Rick Jonah before? Rick Jonah, a member of the prophets in America, and they told him who he is. And that's why you see him talk so well. In fact, sometimes he uses his mouth anyhow. You know, somebody when you are too confident, you do some things anyhow. And they told him, oh God, don't worry. Even if they don't like him, you will win. How did they know? Somebody said they were doing a council meeting in heaven. And the head of that council meeting is called Abraham. Why? Abraham is the father of nations. So in heaven, because God still rules in the affairs of men, they must call Abraham to tell him, to ask him, what do you think we can do about the situation of this planet? Listen to me. And Abraham said, well, Father, we brought Obama in, and this and that. But yet, let's try another man. And he said, who do we call? Call the trumpet. Call what? The trumpet does not blow itself. Somebody must what? How many of you know that? Can the trumpet blow itself? So I will just blow. I will use the trumpet as a message to the world. I will use it to communicate something to the world, to this perverse generation. U.S. was supposed to be the defender of the world. How many of you know? How many of you know that we were the one that loved that destiny? United States of Africa, not America. United States of America was supposed to be formed with Israel, the head. With Israel what? Oh, the day they cut off Israel from Africa, Africa became what it becomes. The only thing that we can do now is if we have a president that just decide to say, I, so person, align with Israel. Check. Just check in the next 2 years to see what Nigeria will go. Ambassador was supposed to be the one to do it. He didn't soldier anything. Only thing is planning. Now, do you know what he did? He brought Festa what? 77. Festa 77, how many of you know Festa 77? It's the sin Nigeria committed. Now, do you know this year they are going to do 40th anniversary? And it's even seeking for solicitation from all the African countries. And over 42 countries as what? Deciding to bring back idol. And 40 years means the year that even God will lead you out of captivity and you go into what? Productivity. He's bringing us back into captivity by his, what you call, his birthday. By his birthday, he's going to declare Nigeria still back into captivity for the next 40 years. What do you have men and women in Nigeria to do? I believe that if I can just see that the people here will prosper and say that enjoy. You understand what it means? Please help me call this man to order. Because if he does that again, Nigeria is in trouble. We may not be able to rise again. They have seen Boko Haram. Boko Haram and the likes of this say, our punishment for what we did in what? First, that's 40 years ago. I want to do it again. They have not seen Boko Haram. You have not seen us. They are still coming back. Another one, more terrible. Why? Because God deals with any country that enters into what? Idolatry. He dealt with Israel because they entered into what? Idolatry. He took them to wilderness. May you not suffer. I said, if they do that thing again, I will take it of relocating from Nigeria. Sincerely. If I see that you are begging, you can talk to this boy. You don't talk to this man not to get to Israel. If I see all the generals, I will beg them. There's nothing they should not look for Boko Haram. They should look for Basra and tell him, this man, don't do this thing. What? Again, he's giving up. He was supposed to connect Nigeria agriculture, infrastructure, and even the oil, the so-called, what do you call this, refinery to Israel. How many of you know Israel can do the refinery perfectly? How many of you know? As fast as time, but he didn't know. Nobody to tell him. Now again, he did the other way around. He brought Festa 77, and this time again, he's coming back to do it. If I see Professor Shibaji, I'll tell him, go and beg him to stop that idea. He's not promoting culture. Anything that does not promote the scripture is going to make us captured. Anything that does not promote what? The scripture will make us what? So line your life by the scripture. Then that's the only way you can be what? Captured.
Lift up your hand. Time will not permit you to go on to this today. I'm praying to God that God will raise a voice from this church.
Before they come with that satanic group, before they mean that thing,
God will raise a voice that will tell them. Is anybody here that God will raise? I believe God will raise Esther here. I believe God will raise Nehemiah here. I believe God will raise Jeremiah here. I believe God will raise Isaiah here. I believe God will raise Elijah here. In the name of Jesus.
So if I'm a prophet of Nigeria, what am I saying? Say no to Fester 77.
If I were you, go and tweet against it. Go and use your Facebook. Go and use everything and say we don't want Fester 77 again.
And if you need information, I can send it to you to tell them we don't want it.
Okay, search for Martin Walash on Facebook and check my profile there and get all the information you need to get about Fester 77.
Quiet it
and say we don't want.
Or else, we're in trouble.
He will soon die and leave us in trouble. Lift up your hand.
The revival we need in Nigeria is no more idolatry.
Yes.
So lift up your hand and say, Father. Say, Father. Say, Father. Forgive us. Forgive our nation. For the perversion of Esther 77. In the name of Jesus. That is the first prayer I want you to pray. Forgive our nation about the abomination of Esther 77. Forgive our nation, O Lord. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Second prayer. Say, Father, this first act renewal that they want to do this year. Scatter it! Open your mouth and pray. Raise a voice that will scatter it. Father, raise a national voice that will scatter it. 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 Shadabaraba sakatalabaya. Lipateke soso pita. Eka rubeli azagagash. Eka lopo ziatata. Ela dulusipata. Yes, Lord. Raise a national voice that will scatter it. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
So in case I don't, I believe God that there are people here that God can use. So in case you know anybody in power, take your phone and call them. If you can meet with Daddy Joe, speak to Daddy Joe and say, Daddy, you understand this. Talk to this man to stop this evil. If they continue this evil, our generation will be in jeopardy. But pray for yourself. Leave that as a final prayer. Say, Father,
Father,
revive me into my original destiny. If you are serious about it tonight, God will show you a revelation of direction. Lift up your two hands and say, Father, revive me to my original destiny. Show me who I am. Open your mouth and pray before I pray for you. Open your mouth. Show me who I am. I don't want to walk amiss again. I don't want to go contrary to your purpose. Show me who I am. Masute parabayagada. Shetele borabada. Shandele karubetilia. Shitata parobetia. Ikato libaraya. Azeso sitalabash. Itele pegele bosha. Palita chiliruma. Shandali bosha. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Can you lift up your two hands as I bless you by the spirit of the prophet? Lord, I speak as a national prophet. And I'm praying for every man that can say the loudest amen. The Esther in this place, the Nehemiah, the Jeremiah, the Jehu, the kings of this place that the Lord has chosen to rule this nation, the Davids. May the Lord open your eyes in the name of Jesus. I looked at the vision of this church and it said, raising leaders of transformation, raising leaders that will change the nation to the divine agenda. Father, the leader that you are destined for this place, and that's why I'm here.
Lord, I can see some leaders hidden in this place. I command him be activated in Jesus' name. Right here you are, by the power of the Holy Ghost, be activated, 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 be activated. I command your guardian angel to arise and help you activate that in Jesus' name. By the big code of your life, called Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree by that spiritual key, I activate you and I kickstart you into your destiny. In the name of Jesus, receive your destiny, receive your destiny, receive your destiny, man. 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 And from today, by the Spirit of God, Mandele Asharabash. Impatali Patilia Sata. Everyone here that is meant to be great and meant to be leader of this nation, to take this nation from a session to possessing their possession, I command, rise and shine! Rise by fire! 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 Those gifts that the Lord has given to you today, the enemy will not steal it away. Everyone here that wants to become a force to be reckoned with, I command by the power of the Holy Ghost, let your IQ be powered. Be powered by the Holy Ghost. 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 From today, you shall become a voice of revolution. You shall become a voice of solution. The Lord shall visit in your dream with revelations of elevation, with revelations of direction. Finally, I prophesy to your life. From today, your journey to royalty begins now. 2 years back, Donald Trump would not know that he will become the president of America. Even with all the opposition, God put him in position. Now I tell you, with all the oppositions writing against you, standing against you, if your amen can be seven resound, and you can say the loudest amen in this place, even with the opposition facing your destiny, you shall rule on your throne.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.